most anticipated and exciting tag team matchups in World Wrestling Federation history. The former champions, the Head Shrinkers, are hot on the coattails of the current WWF Tag Team title holders, the Heartbreak Kid Shawn Michaels, and the awesome 7-Foot Diesel. The no-nonsense Head Shrinkers, as of late, have been annihilating the competition here in the WWF with their vast arsenal of high-impact maneuvers, especially the Samoan Splash off the top rope. Imagine the impact as the 320-pound Fatu comes crashing down on your chest. Not for me, thank you, but it could happen to one of these guys. The incredibly cocky team of Shawn Michaels and Diesel captured the gold approximately 5 weeks ago. Since then, using the speed, agility, and wrestling knowledge of Shawn Michaels, combined with the size and raw power of Big Daddy Cool, the dynamic duo have made a very formidable and dangerous force to be reckoned with. The team continues to mock the Head Shrinkers at every turn, including a modified form of that big splash where the boy toy leaps off the shoulders of Diesel to get that higher elevation as well as pick up some quick, frequent flyer mileage. Let's hear from the champions.
As usual, the rumors are flying around the World Wrestling Federation. Everybody trying to see if there's dissension between Big Daddy Cool and the Heartbreak Kid. Well, I got news for you. Head Shrinkers and tag teams of the World Wrestling Federation, you could use that kind of dissension, because look at it. These two guys are the World Wrestling Federation tag team champions. We're still a unit. We're hotter than ever. The new generation is upon us, and Big Daddy Cool and the Heartbreak Kid are at the helm.
Without a doubt, the finest tag team in World Wrestling Federation history. Watch us. Check us out.
Yokozuna, we thought you might like this viewpoint, because Yokozuna, the next time you look into the coldness of these eyes, you'll be looking up from this casket. Yokozuna, prepare to meet the wrath of the Undertaker. Prepare to rest in peace.
Would you please welcome a man who is red, white, and blue to his soul. Here he is, made in the USA, the one and the only, Lex Luger. As a matter of fact, a poll conducted just prior to SummerSlam, some 54% of the fans that were surveyed felt that you had sold out to Ted DiBiase, the Million Dollar Man. Now, I wonder whether or not you hold any animosity, as far as the fans are concerned, for feeling that way.
It was a very frustrating feeling for me, because all I could do was deny the allegations that had flat out refused the offers made by Ted DiBiase and get out there and prove myself at SummerSlam.
Indeed, I don't think anyone will ever doubt your word. No one will ever doubt your integrity ever, ever again, but nonetheless, to talk a totally different story.
Tataka, I hope you go to that bank each and every day and count all that money and look down to the face on that money. It won't be a face of a president of the United States. It'll be a face of those fans that you sold out who believed in you, of those little children. Tatanka, let me tell you one thing. The buck stops here.
Ladies and gentlemen, here's Made in USA. Give it up for Lex Luger.
Ladies and gentlemen, my guest this week is accompanied by the million-dollar man, Ted DiBiase.
What I want. Yes, I offered Lex Luger a very, very lucrative deal. And he flat turned me down. Lex Luger, you were stupid. You were foolish. Nobody turns down my generosity without paying a price. And at SummerSlam, you paid a price. And you will continue to pay that price. You took the hook and ran with it. That's right. All along you thought I wanted you, but from the very beginning, Tatanka and I had made the deal. Oh yes, I was looking for an All-American. But then it hit me. Luger, you're not a real American. However, Tatanka is a Native American. Tatanka is a true American. Tatanka appreciates the value of the almighty dollar. Tell him, Tatanka.
That's right, million dollar man. I understand the value of a dollar, traitor. Won't you morons just shut up? Thing, I'm proud to be a member of the corporation. Take a good look at me now, Lex. I'm wearing $1,000 Italian wool suits. Take a good look at this. 18 karat gold Gucci tells me my time now. I'm draped in diamonds and I'm draped in gold. And you know what else? Due to the generosity of the million dollar man, I also got a win at SummerSlam. Huh. You so-called American Lex Luger, what did you get? We got the meal, and all you got was the $100 tip.
Well, all those things don't make you a man, Tatanka. You're a poor excuse for a human being.
The matchup that's going to be, everybody remembers Lex Luger coming down the ringside to take a closer look at last week's Tatanka Razor Ramon matchup. No love lost between Tatanka and Lex Luger. And then from behind, Bam Bam Bigelow attacking Lex Luger. So again, it's going to be the Million Dollar Man's assets laying on the line. Bam Bam Bigelow against Lex Luger. However, when we return, the women's tag team matchup. Stay with us. Yeah, wow, Zion Sanders is figuring out his favorite breakfast. Oh my, yes, the fireworks are going to go off in the WWF Action Zone. We're not going to listen to Greg Gumball do any talking. We're not going to listen to Mike Sitka speak. No, we're not talking about any talking at all. We're talking about the WWF Action Zone premiering right here on the USA Network, October 23. That's approximately 3 weeks from now.
What great-looking athletes in the ring right now. Roseanne Barr, eat your heart out. We know you like to eat. These ladies are going to be grappling.
Yeah, well, there's another lady in the news, if you will. Whoopi Goldberg was married this past weekend to Lyle Trachtenberg, and the only thing stranger than that marriage might be the casket match on the WWF Heart Attack Tour.
I heard Lyle's gonna give Whoopi a doinks Whoopi cushion.
Who knows? Heidi Lee Morgan starting things off for her team against Luna Vachon.
That's just to clear the air, I might add.
Of course. And Luna, quite the aggressor. And to the buckle, no! She puts up brakes over her lady and threw the legs in, up and down. One, two, this one's up. No, it's not.
That is an incredible move.
Yes, indeed. Heidi Lee Morgan almost pinning Luna Vachon moments ago. Off the rope now, and flag body press. One, two, and another near fall.
The joy of wrestling by Heidi Morgan.
Uh-oh, and a reverse knife edge there by Luna Vachon. Heidi Lee Morgan off the rope again, and whoa, this time. Luna Vachon was waiting for her.
I got a headache from watching that move.
You might get a headache to watch Bull Nakano. She might get a headache if she looks in the mirror. What a big, awesome monster this Bull Nakano is.
I just had a heck of a thought. Bull Nakano in a bunny costume. And Roseanne Barr in a bunny costume. I pick.
What a tag team that would make.
I'll pick both of them.
Imagine a matchup, Bull Nakano against Roseanne Barr.
If I'm going to go strange, I'm going all the way.
Who would the guest referee be in that particular matchup?
Buddy Ryan, because he wouldn't meet the condition my condition was in, Macho Ball.
I see. Well, Mr. Ryan, victorious, of course, this weekend. Congratulations. And oh, my, a cover, two, and a kick out. And thus far, this has been all Luna Vachon and Heidi Lee Morgan. Nakano yet to officially get in the match, as well as the WWF Women's Champion, Alundra Blayze.
Heidi's got to get out of that corner.
And right now, she's in the clutches, double team effort. Protesting on the backside over there is the champion. Come on, ref, turn around. Heidi Lee Morgan giving away an unbelievable amount of size to Bull Nakano, as anyone would in there against the big bull. Wait a minute, look at this. Off the rope. How about that? Heidi Lee Morgan's holding her own. She's doing more than that. A nice takedown into a cover.
An incredible takedown.
And even more amazing than that, Bull Nakano didn't break her hair. Uh-oh.
Call me crazy, but I'm attracted to Bull Nakano.
You are crazy. You are insane. Look at that. Uh-oh. Hey, how about that? Count round. And the referee really amazed at that pinning combination, as I believe we all were. And now the tag back in, Luna Vachon and Heidi Lee Morgan.
Can you believe this?
And a clothesline of sorts.
This match is raw.
And Heidi Lee Morgan going downstairs with a series of rights and lefts, not too much behind it. Now she's on her feet with more leverage. Heidi Lee Morgan chopping away. Luna for the ride, off the rope, and a drop kick. Nicely done.
Heidi's got spunk.
Heidi does. Now Heidi should tag out. Tag in the champion. A scoop and a slap. And a... No. How did she miss that? She was raw. I see now. She wasn't going for the cover. Here comes the champion. Luna Vachon didn't quite make the tag. And Alundra Blayze. Nice maneuver.
Check out this fire.
And an ally. Alundra Blayze taking it to Luna.
shot. Luna would like nothing but hate. She does make the tag.
This is going to be a confrontation.
Big, awesome Bull Nakano. A tremendous athlete, the best the country of Japan can offer here in the WWF. And wait a minute, Heidi Lee Morgan's coming in from the far side, but so is Luna Vachon. The official better get control of this matchup quickly. Double team effort behind the official's back. Now wait a minute, look at this. Fine body pass on both women.
These Luna ladies are getting unruly.
Yes, it, can she get her up? And no, not quite. Nope. And what's this? Wait a minute. There's one way she could go up. If she's double teamed, then she won. No.
Impressive. Oh, I don't care what anybody says. Bull Nakano's strong and pretty.
She's not pretty, but she is strong. And missing with the roundhouse kick. Oh, right on target. Right into the chops. And an underblaze to the buckle. Look at now. Flying body pass. Yeah, she gets Bull Nakano two in. No, almost a count of three.
These women are great.
What a matchup. Luna Vachon along with Bull Nakano facing an underplays and Heidi Lee Morgan. No, look at that. Wow.
Bull Nakano can pin them both right now.
Nakano tagging in Luna Vachon and underplays is the legal competitor from the top rope. No.
Air traffic control made a mistake. You are scared.
This. Suplex. One, two, yes.
It's over.
The German suplex applied on Luna Vachon, the WWF Women's Champion, Alundra Blaze and her partner, Heidi Lee Morgan, victorious.
I'm going to the party to celebrate.
Sounds good to me. Stay tuned, everybody.
Right now, however, the World Wrestling Federation champion himself, Brett, thanks for staying back with us. First of all, congratulations to your brother-in-law, the British Bulldog.
Yeah, he had his hands full in there.
No question about that, but it seemed as though you are about to have your hands full as well. Bob Backlund came down to ringside. Can you enlighten us as to what Bob Backlund was saying to you out there?
I don't know. You know, I think that Bob's kind of losing his marbles or something, you know, because he was talking about he's the world champion and he's never been beat. You know, I beat Bob Backlund not that long ago either. He already had his shot, and I got, you know, I got a dozen guys that have all earned title shots, and it's my job to take on all challenges, but Bob had his challenge. And I respect Bob, and I appreciate, you know, that he wants another shot, but he's got to get in line. And as far as Bob Backlund goes, I've already beaten Bob Backlund. I don't know what he's talking about. I think he's losing it.
Well, he certainly has never been the same since that loss to you. We appreciate the fact that you are the fighting champion of all time, and many would say the greatest. The best of luck to you in the future, and thanks for joining us.
Thank you.
Good luck, Brett.
Join us next week for more Monday Night Raw. So long, everybody.
Welcome, everyone, to WWF Action. Yes, the dollar signs lead the way for the Million Dollar Man, Ted DiBiase, and his latest protege. Yes, Bam Bam Bigelow, the beast from the east.
That's right, the head man in the Million Dollar Man's corporation. I can guarantee it. Look at these people with the thumbs down. They're just jealous of all the money that Ted has.
The beast from the east, a pillar member of Ted DiBiase's corporation. Take a look at this monster. Bam Bam Bigelow, one-on-one with Duke the Dumpster Drosy, kicking things off here this week. What a matchup that's going to be. Bam Bam, one of the more ambitious WWF superstars. Today, he has his work cut out for him.
Oh, Bam Bam is fixing to do some trash compacting. Just watch it.
Welcome, everyone, to WWF Action. Vince McMahon here along with Jerry the King Lawler. And yes, as you can see in the squared circle right now, Bam Bam Bigelow awaiting his opponent. The man who's going to take out the trash here in the WWF, in reference, of course, to Duke the Dumpster Drosy.
Not that stinking trash man. I heard that when he comes by your house, he asks if you want pickup or delivery.
In action now with leaders, ladies and gentlemen, to the man from England, yes, former Intercontinental Champion, the British Bulldog.
That's right, he's from England, the land of kings, right? Not anymore. The
WWF is becoming the land of kings, because you see, you have me, the king. You have Owen, the king of hearts. And this week, the debut of another king. King Kong Bundy.
All of that in addition to the fact, ladies and gentlemen, we'll give you the WWF version of Tales from the Crypt. Yes, we will hear once again from The Undertaker. There's no question this will be the toughest test yet for Duke the Dumpster Grossi, notwithstanding the battle, if you would call it that, 3 weeks ago when the Dumpster met Jerry the King Lawler. And I do remember the results of that matchup. I believe it was a win in the column of Duke the Dumpster Grossi. Thanks, of course, to a Deke in a trash can. For those of you who missed that, that was a riot.
Would you quit?
The King was outside, lifted the top off the trash can, and you were squirted. Yeah.
Don't remind me, McMahon.
Uh-huh.
Look at this guy. Look how big he is.
Bam, bam. Must have been a roundhouse. On target. Look at this. The Dumpster hammered away on the Beast from the East.
What a cheater.
And it's Bam Bam for the ride to the reversal. Nicely done. Oh, right into the boot.
The
clothesline.
Can you imagine the stench from his feet?
I know. What do you mean by that?
Well, he put him right in Bam Bam's face. Knocked any man to his knees.
And winding up now, working on the rest. Duke the Dumpster Grossi, the million-dollar man, looking on, cannot like what he sees at the moment.
He got to go around and check that garbage can out, see if there's anything in it.
Oh, look at that maneuver. That was nicely done.
Dump in the trash.
From a wrist, a lock to a somewhat of an arm drag there, and now Bam trying to keep the Dumpster out of the squared circle.
Good move.
Bam Bam Bigelow. Marianne Vicious, as we stated earlier on, meeting Duke the Dumpster Grossi here this week. And this Monday, it's Bam Bam Bigelow against a man made in the USA, Lex Luger. Back-to-back battles for Bam Bam.
What an impressive win streak that would be. Defeat the Dumpster and then go on and defeat the man made in the USA.
Well, that would be impressive.
He would truly be the head man in the corporation then.
All right, Bam Bam Bigelow with the Dumpster down to canvas. Down! The headbutt again. Bam Bam with the cover and almost hits the Dumpster. Count of two. Bam Bam now trying to pour it on. Stalking Duke the Dumpster Grossi. This is the biggest man I'm sure the Dumpster has ever faced. Bam Bam with the Dumpster across the top rope now. Bam Bam Bigelow taking on all comers these days.
Getting ready to move up that corporate ladder.
Oh, is he now?
That's right.
Adam Bomb is hot on Bam Bam's trail. Lex Luger waiting for this Monday. And Duke the Dumpster Grossi battling it out as Ted DiBiase with that solemn face looks on.
He looked like the stock market just crashed, didn't he?
No, he's happy. He's confident. He knows.
Cover again and almost gets it for a second time.
I think that referee's a little slow on his count.
One of the more efficient referees, I might add, is Bam Bam Bigelow. Now reverse chin lock. And again, Ted DiBiase, the million-dollar man, not very happy at all.
Oh, he's got a big smile on his face. He's just thinking what kind of little treat he's going to get for the Bammer when he wins this match. You know he does that.
He does that.
A little treat when his guys win.
A few dog biscuits or what?
Oh, no.
What's
are you
guy
kidding
about?
Me? This guy is first class all the way. Why, when he even goes to a fast food restaurant, it's high class. You ever heard of Kentucky Fried Pheasant?
Kentucky Fried Pheasant?
That's right. That's what you get when you go with the million-dollar man.
Oh, my, did you see that? Bam Bam spinning a 300-pound Dumpster in midair with the knee lift to the midsection.
Oh, I think it's getting ready to be over.
Bam Bam Bigelow could be the first champion in Ted DiBiase's corporation. He is really on a tear as of late.
Mommy, take him out, throw him in the garbage.
Yeah, oh, you hear that?
Yes. Into the garbage. That's what you told me about 3 weeks ago.
Be careful with that can.
That's right. No telling who's going to be in there. Could be Deacon. A tackle down goes the Dumpster. Bam Bam Bigelow now trying to finish off Duke the Dumpster Grossi. Another tackle. Bam Bam with things well in control, it would appear. Bam Bam Bigelow going to the ropes again. Cover! One!
Look at the smile on Ted DiBiase, would you?
Yeah, well, get used to it, McMahon, because he's going to be back in a big way.
What?
I think I'm cute. I know I'm sexy.
Welcome once again, all you cats and kittens, to the Heartbreak Hotel. Home of the World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Champions Big Daddy Cool and the Heartbreak Kid, not to mention home of the new generation of the World Wrestling Federation, your captain being yours truly, the Heartbreak Kid Shawn Michaels, and you, Big Daddy Cool Diesel. But you know something? There's a guy around here that is not exactly what you would call part of the new generation here in the World Wrestling Federation, but nonetheless, he is a part of the World Wrestling Federation. We'll call him the Backlund Generation. Ladies and gentlemen, my guest this week on the Heartbreak Hotel is none other than former World Wrestling Federation Champion, Bob Backlund.
Uh-oh. They do not like it. No. No one likes this Bob Backlund. At one time, Bob Backlund was thought of highly in the World Wrestling Federation. No longer.
Bob,
as far
Backlund
as popularity is concerned.
Don't be afraid, Bob. I'm here to be your friend. I know what those hands have done lately, and I'm willing to take my chances. Okay. Bob, you have undergone
two mistakes. It's Mr. Backlund, and I resent the term former. I resent the term former.
Mr. Backlund, last thing a Heartbreak Kid wants is a problem with you, Mr. Backlund. So I'm going to give you whatever you want. And I understand where you're coming from, Bob, because I've been there, okay?
Mr. Backlund,
I've been there. But right now, the World Wrestling Federation recognizes one man as the World Wrestling Federation champion. And that man is Bret the Hitman Hart. Easy, Mr. Backlund.
Ladies and gentlemen, let me take you back. How do you lose or gain a championship?
By submission or pinfall?
Not by a towel entering the ring during a match. The belt was procured in the wrong way, and I was ostracized from professional wrestling for 10 years. I've been waiting patiently, diligently, assiduously for this moment.
Alrighty then. Mr. Backlund, you, my friend, have undergone some serious changes as of late. I mean, when I saw you clamp on that chicken wing on that young man on Monday Night Raw, Mr. Backlund, you, my friend, are a madman. And Big Daddy Cool and I want to party with you, pal.
First thing, Big Daddy Cool and Shawn Michaels aren't in my league, my society, my generation. And I'm not so sure I would want to accept you in my generation. But the thing I'm out here to do is issue a challenge to a man that's quagmired in a sea of hypocrisy and engulfed in a river of lies. And I'm not going to be fallacious with this young man. I'm not going to vacillate from one idea to another. I'm going to come out and tell him just exactly where it lies. Bob Backlund is the WWF champion. You've got the belt. I've been waiting for 10 years. Walk out here and wrestle me.
Rest assured, Mr. Backlund, Big Daddy Cool and the Heartbreak Kid know you are definitely no part of our
generation. But those of us who don't have a Webster's Dictionary, for those of us in the nosebleed section, in the cheap seats, if you will, could you come down to our level, Mr. Backlund, and explain just exactly, in layman's terms, where in the world you are coming from?
Since July 3rd, 1994, I don't come down to anybody's level. You come up to my level, or you don't fit, or you don't play in my game. You don't fit into our society, because we're gonna have a utopia. If you play the game right, you're gonna win. If you play like they do, you're gonna bound to lose. You'll lose the game. You've lost it already.
Bunch of losers, McMahon. Look at them.
They lost the game. They don't know how to play. And I'm serious. I worry about you people. Chuck, Bret Hart, I've been waiting. And you got two ways you can do it. You can come out here and give it to me right now, so the rightful owner can defend it proudly. Or you can wait and we'll fight it out in the middle of the ring.
And Bob Backlund, the former WWF champion.
Lost it? No, I don't think so. Till next time, see ya, and I wouldn't think I'd wanna be ya.
Yokozuna. Did you honestly think that you were capable of destroying the most powerful entity in the World Wrestling Federation today? Did you honestly think that you put an end to The Undertaker? Yokozuna, the time has come for you to pay for your crimes. Yokozuna, it's time for you to face the Reaper once more.
Oh, yes. The Heart Attack Tour. Because of your unwillingness to listen to the warnings of my Undertaker, Yokozuna, have a view of your final resting place. Oh, yeah!
You know, he used to be a lifeguard at a car wash. He used to throw everybody a towel when their car got finished being washed. That's what he did. He threw in the towel on Bob Backlund. Mr. Bob Backlund, you. I can't wait to hear what his explanation is.
Everybody's.
Wait a minute. Speaking of explanations, what's the explanation of this? Ted DiBiase is out there with King Kong Bundy.
That's the surprise I was telling you about, McMahon. What do you think?
That is a big surprise. Take a look at the gargantuan girth of King Kong Bundy. This guy's a walking bust. Look at him.
$1 million man doesn't do anything small time.
No, that's not small time at all. Last we saw King Kong Bundy, he was battling New York City. Matter of fact, I think he had his streets mixed up, though.
Why is that?
Well, because the Empire State Building is a little bit further down. He was climbing the Chrysler Building.
Of course, he did that on purpose. That old dilapidated Empire State Building is not structurally sound enough to withstand.
Wait a minute. Now, Donald Trump bought the Empire State Building. He's not going to buy anything that isn't structurally sound.
Well, let's just say that King Kong Bundy thought that it would take the Chrysler Building to hold him up.
Wait a minute, back into the corner now, we have Mitch Bishop.
Oh, my goodness.
Bundy with a chop. And Bishop for the ride.
And Bundy moving in. Look at the size disparity between King Kong Bundy and Mitch Bishop.
Oh, Bundy's huge, all right. But just think of the acquisition of King Kong Bundy by the Million Dollar Man. Well, it's bigger than the Louisiana Purchase, McMahon.
It probably is. I mean, this is really big news. DiBiase with tremendous resources, and what an asset now he has in King Kong's foot. Oh, my goodness.
What do you think of his corporation now? It'll be soaring right to the top of the Fortune 500, won't it?
I would suspect it just might. Ted DiBiase on a tear as of late. And unfortunately for Mitch Bishop, he's yet to mount up an offense. Look out! Oh, my goodness! Bishop will rue the day that he signed on to match against this man. Forget about it. Wait a minute.
Wait, he wants a five count, McMahon.
Bundy insists on a five count. King Kong Bundy.
He is the winner.
He is colossal.
King
Look at this man. Look at his neck, the shoulders. Everybody has a price. Certainly King Kong Bundy had a price for the $1 million man. Ted DiBiase, but Bam Bam Bigelow, King Kong Bundy, Native American Tataka, Irwin R. Scheister and more.
Hey, McMahon, I want to show you something. Don't go away.
Promotional consideration paid for by the following.
Now take a look at this, McMahon. Matter of fact, take a look at this, everybody. Because we want the world to know what is in the future of anybody who faces King Kong Bundy.
It's worth a million words.
You hear that? Picture's worth a million words.
King Kong Bundy, ladies and gentlemen, with a very impressive debut on WWF Superstars. Stand by for the live event news. And then from there, we're going to show you a clip of the film, Ed Wood. Lots more coming up. Here we go. Welcome back, everyone. Vince McMahon, Jerry the King Lawler. I must say, King Kong Bundy is very, very impressive.
Exactly. Another king to be reckoned with here in the World Wrestling Federation.
And yet so...
Hey, King! Hey, King Kong!
What is this? Look at this idiot over here.
Hey, Jerry the King Lawler!
What?
I guess you think you're the king of jokes. You think you're the king of wrestling?
Yeah.
How would you like me to come down in your ring right now? We have a little match, King.
Well, what about it? What about it, Jerry Lawler?
You mean he, you want me and him in a ring right now?
Come on, Burger King.
Hey, I'll tell you what.
Why, you getting a little upset at the Prince of Pranks? You know something, Jerry Lawler? I can play a joke on you right now, and you can't even stop it.
Oh, I'll tell you what. Hey, why don't you just
You're
come
so
on right?
You're so stupid, what? Jerry Lawler.
Hey, wait a minute. What's he doing? Where are you going? Are you going down to the ring? What are you doing?
Jerry Lawler, you're getting in deeper and deeper as I speak.
Hey, wait a minute. What's going on here? Jerry Lawler, you're actually going to take him on?
Oh, Jerry Lawler, you're like a fish with
why
a big hook
come
and
on
you're down in the ring.
Right now, the ring's right over here. You just come on out. You got a white face. You got green hair. Why don't you turn around and show everybody that big yellow streak down your back?
Oh, Jerry Lawler, I'm not yellow. But please, there's no reason for you to get upset. Ruin the show. Why don't you just sit down and take it easy?
Well, I thought he's admitting. Why don't you go ahead and admit it? You're scared of me, huh?
Jerry, I'm not scared of you. I just want you to relax and have a good time. Why don't you please sit down and just enjoy
the show? I guess everybody sees there's not going to be any match. He's scared.
All right, there you have it, ladies and gentlemen. Jerry the King Lawler. Hey, wait a minute.
Jerry Lawler.
Look what. You just stepped in.
Oh, Jerry Lawler.
You just stepped in a pond. You just stepped in.
Oh, boy. Jerry. Hey, Jerry.
Look what you did.
Jerry, I sent you a little something to eat. You looked a little thin.
I've heard of pie in the face before, but this is ridiculous.
That's a pie in the face.
So long, everyone. Till we see you next week for more WWF action. Good jokes on you.
It's Monday Night Raw. It's the sign of the dollar bill. It's the sign of Ted DiBiase. And yes, representing Bam Bam Bigelow tonight on Monday Night Raw, Bam Bam against Lex Luger. Well, wait a minute. This is supposed to be single competition. What's going on, Randy Savage?
Strength in numbers, McMahon. Obviously, Bam Bam Bigelow doesn't think he can beat Lex Luger by himself.
Ted DiBiase, the manager. And indeed, the proprietor, if you would, of his million-dollar team. And DiBiase with his own parade, his own Columbus Day parade, coming down the ringside. You have to wonder, what's going on in the mind of Lex Luger? What's Lex Luger going to do about this? Will he come out by himself? Or will he bring his own entourage with him? Who knows what's going to happen tonight on Monday Night Raw?
And a rather disgruntled Jerry the King Lawler.
All right, you peons, listen up. Because this is going to be one of the shortest King Courts ever.
Great. Let's have that in writing.
No.
Not if Princess Di is here, it won't be short.
When I say it's going to be short, it's because I'm going to be talking about short people.
Watch
it. I hate short people. You understand that?
Wait a minute. What's this about?
I mean, I went to see Wizard of Oz and rooted for the witches.
That's not surprising.
Now, talking about short people, that brings us to the subject of Dink. That little sawed-off runt that follows Doink around. I'd like to call him short to his face, but I can't bend down that low, if you know what I mean.
I bet he could.
But I have got somebody that can bend down that low. Because you see, I thought I had made my point with Dink a time or two, if you know what I mean. I thought that I had gotten him out of my hair, but it seems like every time I turn around, he's still underfoot. So what I'm gonna do is, I'm gonna introduce you morons to somebody who is gonna take care of Dink for the King. You heard of the seven dwarfs? There was Happy, there was Grumpy, there was Sleepy and Sneezy and even Dopey. Well, Dink is the eighth dwarf. He's ugly. But I'll tell you who I've got, and I'm gonna bring him out here right now on the King's Court. I named him after what he's gonna make Dink feel like when Dink sees him. I call him Queasy, and I want you to welcome him right now. Come on out here, Queasy. Oh, yeah.
You've got to be kidding me. Queasy?
Yeah,
I'm feeling a little queasy.
Wait a minute. Doink has Dink. And now Jerry the King Lawler has Queasy.
We're just going to have to get a pie for Queasy, that's all.
Eat your heart out, Dink. Dink is about 2'12" tall. But Queasy right here is about 10 feet tall when he gets in the ring. Come on, stand up. Show some respect to the man who is going to take care of that runt, Dink.
How about that?
Yeah. I want to ask you, morons, who's the smartest man in wrestling and why am I?
Jerry the King Lawler.
Queasy.
Settling the score somewhat, as far as odds are concerned.
This is going to have that little runt, Dink, back doing the only job that he's qualified to do, and that's being a desk clerk at a roach motel. Come here. Tell all of these peons exactly what you're going to do to Dink if he gets underfoot again.
I'm going to king. I'm going to squash him like the bug that he is. Then I'm going to scrape him off the bottom of my shoe.
Did you morons hear that? Come here, Queasy. Tell them exactly why you're going to do that to that little runt.
They're going to be like you and me, King.
He's not royalty.
We're royalty, King, you and me.
We are royalty. Did you understand that? You little runt, Dink, like I said, very shortly, if you know what I mean, this man right here is going to be in your dreams. You're going to have a little nightmare courtesy of Queasy. How about a high five, baby? Oh, hey, come here. Why don't we go now and let these morons kiss your little royal feet on the way out, okay?
Okay, King.
Give me a break. We've heard of the court jester before, but Queasy? Yes, indeed, the new WWF generation in a brand new television show right here on USA. Ladies and gentlemen, the Action Zone premiering in less than 2 weeks. We're talking Sunday afternoon, 12 Eastern time. Sunday afternoon, October 23, the WWF champion Bret Hart defending the title against his brother Owen in Owen's last attempt to win the championship.
It's going to be a gunfight. High noon, Action Zone. The King of Hearts versus the Hitman. I can see it now.
And speaking of challengers, that will, of course, lead us to the gentlemen who have just been introduced. The Head Shrinkers, who are challenging on the WWF Tag Team Championship. And all of a sudden, Captain Louis Albano has a brand new head shrinker.
And he beat Cousin Cioni, and he's a big, big man.
You might say he's the more barbaric, I would suggest, of the family members.
What do you mean by that, big man?
Take a look at him.
You're Cioni, right.
Cioni and Fatu together. And I would suggest that there's been a little bit of confusion, likely to continue to be, on the part of the tag team title holders. Shawn Michaels, along with his partner, the seven-foot monster Diesel. I mean, which two of the three head shrinkers will Michaels and Diesel have to face? Right now, it's going to be Cioni starting things off. The new head shrinker, if you would. Cioni against Corey Studit. Studit in weight, certainly equaling the size of Cioni. Standing side headlock off the rope, and no one goes anywhere. Trying it again. All right, here we go. Corey Studit off the rope, and missing with the roundhouse, right back in.
Back body drop.
Ooh. Speaking of Shawn Michaels, can you imagine Michaels? How is he qualified to give advice to the Lovelorn? Ooh, advice to the Lovelorn, if you would. In the WWF magazine, Michaels now, not only a co-holder of the Tag Team Championship, but he fancies himself, I guess, some sort of a therapist, if you would.
Well, I've got a couple of letters into him right now, so I'll let you know how they turn out.
J.S. Storm having his problems, as I would suggest anyone who takes advice about their love life from Michaels is going to have, oh my, with a power slam. Also in the magazine, Randy Savage, what are you doing giving it up? My goodness, we're talking the inside of the Macho Man. Look at that. Sort of an in-depth interview, if you would, sort of getting personal, huh?
I just felt like telling all.
You and Burt Reynolds. Off the rope and, oh, Mike, did you see that?
That is the most I've never, ever.
Cioni with the cover, why bother?
In my entire life. I think we're seeing the new and improved version of the head shrinkers.
You might be right. And I'll tell you something else, we're gonna see Doink the Clown momentarily. Of course, next week they will clash. Hey, what is that? Are you gonna crown me?
All right.
There you go. Earlier this week, Jerry the King Lawler made reference to Queasy. What about Queasy?
Well, you sure it's not Sneezy, it's Queasy.
All we know is Queasy.
But, you know, right here, this weekend, I got a little surprise for Jerry the King Lawler and Queasy. Just a little surprise.
Just a little bit, huh?
Yeah, just a little.
All right, best of luck, ladies and gentlemen.
Okay, right here.
And by the way, thanks for the crown, yes.
My crown's better than your crown.
I think you're right. Join us next week, ladies and gentlemen, for our Monday Night Raw.
Unquestionably, Arnold, you've done many things in your long and illustrious career as a professional wrestler, many great accomplishments, but one of them, certainly, it would be as a manager, managing what was then the WWF champion at the time, Mr. Bob Backlund.
That's true. Vince, you know, first time I saw Bob Backlund, he was in the Nationals. He was a great, I could see he was a great wrestler. He had a lot of intestinal fortitude. And I said, this is the kind of guy that can make it. So I trained with him for 6 months, and he became like a son to me. And, you know, after that, he won the title, and he held it for 6 years.
Indeed, Bob Backlund held the title for 6 years, and under your guidance and tutelage all the way, since bringing him from the amateur ranks into the pros.
Come on, McMahon.
And then there came a rather fateful night in December of 1983 when Bob Backlund was in a rather precarious position, a submission hold, as it were. And you threw the towel in on Bob Backlund, did you
why?
Not?
Well, I did, Vince. You know, it was a hard thing to do. You know, I've known Backlund, and I know what kind of man he was, and I know he would never give up. I was just thinking about his future. That's
right.
The only reason I threw the
you
towel
You want to ruin
in.
His future.
Has Bob Backlund in any way expressed his appreciation for you saving his perhaps career at that time? Has there been any dialogue at all between you and Bob Backlund since December of 1983?
No way at all, Vince. It's been 10 years since I've talked to him. I tried
Here
to get in touch
Backlund.
With him
now
and
we'll
everything.
Get to the bottom of this. He'll make him tell the truth. Get him, Bob.
You have the audacity to come out here and say you wanted to save my career.
Have you ever been in a tornado?
Yeah.
Have you ever been in a hurricane?
Yeah.
Have you ever been in an airplane crash?
Oh.
It felt like an avalanche coming in. I couldn't breathe. I was dying. 10 years. 10 years, Arnold. I waited 10 years every day of my life. I had to work out thinking there was going to be a phone call.
If that's the way you feel, Scullin, I'm really sorry.
There you go.
I'm sorry that's the way you feel, and you were like a son to me. Believe me. You want to shake my hand?
Okay. Wait a minute. You're not going to shake his hand. He just apologized to you. You're not going to shake this man's hand. He built your career.
Oh, give
what
me a break,
man. What kind of respect is that?
He ruined his career.
What's the matter with you? Arnie.
There you go. Oh, look out! Ow! Whoa, what's he doing? Backwards snap. Easy, he has snapped again.
Get some help here.
Chicken wing crossface on Arnold Scullin. Here comes more officials into the ring. Hey, here comes Bob Sparkplug Holly. This guy is nuts. He's a basket case. I don't blame him for what he's doing to Arnold Scullin, but he has definitely snapped. He needs help. Look at him. He's a man possessed. But who wouldn't be? I mean, his entire life was destroyed. WWF Championship meant the world to him. It was all he lived for. It was all he fought for. It was all he thought about. And it was taken away from him by Arnold Scullin. And now, it's come to this 10 years later. Look, what is Holly saying?
What is wrong with you? You hurt that man. And all he did was try to help you.
How can you say try to help him?
I can't believe what you just did.
Scullin is hurt. Look at
that. And all he did.
Look at Backlund. He is in a... Backlund now is in some kind of a trance or something. You better not get too close to him, spark plug. Whoa, McMahon, maybe you shouldn't have asked the hard question, huh? I'll tell you, I have never seen anything like this. Bob Backlund has once again snapped.
Stink having his hand there.
It's no telling. They're always up to something. Or down to something.
Hello, Dink.
Look at that face. Look at that face.
And hello, Dink.
Is he waving at you?
In fact, I think he was. I was waving back nonetheless. He certainly wasn't waving at you.
What is that Dink has in his hand?
Yeah, well, it's certainly not a balloon. 5 weeks ago, Dink was coming down the ringside. Jerry the King Lawler literally burst the balloons that Dink was carrying.
Yeah.
Following that, the following Monday night, what a setup that was when you kicked that trash can loaded with weights in the bottom. Almost broke your toe.
Yeah, thanks so much,
Dink.
Right now.
And then from there, you've got your revenge. You broke the tricycle of Dink when you went down the ringside.
I made it into a unicycle. I did him a favor.
Yeah, sure you did. However, last week, Dink and Dink having some fun when he put that pyro.
What is that?
That's a magic wand. That's almost as great as that tie that was in your chair last week. Dink and Dink.
Whoa! Oh, he thinks that's real funny.
Well, it's clever nonetheless, but not as funny as last week when you sat down in that pie. That was a riot.
No, that wasn't funny at all. Why I went out and got queasy, too.
No wonder your rope stinks. Charlie Mann was right. All right, here we go now.
That. My father is number one. Yay!
Oh, man. Talk about something that stinks.
All right, starting things off now is Doink the Clown squaring off against Corey Studit. Quick throw behind there by Doink. Nice takedown.
What do you think their green hair smells like?
Oh, covered! Well, I don't know. I've never smelled green hair before. Coming off the rope is Corey Studit. Down goes Doink.
Yeah.
Studit off the rope again. Over Doink. Right back. Collision. And no. Nice and tough. And an arm drag follow-up as well.
Like a Dink looking pretty good there. And there you see Dink. And I guess maybe you have answered Dink with the introduction of Queasy. We see the backdrop.
That's right, big man. When Queasy gets through with Dink, he'll be out of the World Wrestling Federation. He'll be back at his old job as a desk clerk at a Roach Motel.
You're a riot.
That's right.
Corey Studer now off the rope and over the goal. Oh,
whoa, yeah.
What a clothesline.
Ah, that could finish Doink off.
And you wonder what's going to happen this Monday night. Will Double J, Jeff Jarrett, finish Doink off? They're on a collision course this Monday night.
Oh, yeah. Double J will have Doink singing a tune. I'll tell you that. I've talked with Double J. We may have a little surprise for him and that little run Dink this Monday night.
Oh, wait a minute now.
What?
Is Queasy going to come down the ring with Double J? What are you up to this Monday?
That wouldn't be a surprise if I told you, McMahon.
And down to the canvas again. Corey Studer having some degree of success thus far with Doink the Clown. Backs him to the corner now, and Doink.
I think he's out on his feet. Uh-oh, no, he ducked.
Corey Studer is...
Uh-oh.
On the receiving end of the knee to the spine area. Clothesline down goes Corey Studer.
Now where's that clown going?
Wait a minute. Going up to the top. Are we going to see it? Are we going to hear it? Yes, ladies. There we go, and the whoopee. Ooh, the whoopee cushion. And the count of three.
And a look over this way at you, King.
Don't worry.
Hey, Dink, bring that magic wand.
No. Don't worry. I'll see you guys Monday night.
That's when Double J locks up live with Doink the Clown. No doubt you might be up to something on Monday, but I believe Doink and Dink will have the last laugh. If only they would bring that magic wand over here.
Don't bet on it, McMahon. And speaking of that, don't ever play cards with Queasy. You know why?
Why?
He bets way over his head.
Oh, please. You may be over your head. Wait a minute. I think Doink's going to say something.
What?
Oh, Your Majesty. Hey, Kingy!
Kingy?
What? What? You know, I guess last week you thought you had one on the Doinkster, huh? Well, you know what? I got a surprise for you. Oh, no. I got a surprise for you, a little Queasy. I want you to meet Wink.
What? Did he say Dink?
You know, Brett, you and I have had matches in the past, but coming up next Sunday, it's you and me for the World Wrestling Federation title match and a last chance match. Well, Brett, I don't need any more chances because it's going to be my night next Sunday. Right, Anvil?
Right, King. You're going to be the next heavyweight champ, baby.
And for you people watching, you get the privilege of watching me coming up next.
He'll make good on that. We'll see a new champion. Hey, speaking of champions, take a look.
Yeah. Coming down the former WWF champion.
What a monster this man is.
And his manager, Mr.
Hey, don't show that magazine to Yokozuna either. He's got a story in there about The Undertaker.
It does indeed, and I would suggest that every time Yokozuna hears about the casket match on the Heart Attack Tour, he goes nuts.
Well, he's almost as bonkers as Bob Backlund when he hears about the casket match.
Jason.
What do you expect, McMahon? That stuff's creepy. Theory, nobody likes to hear about that kind of stuff. What?
Charlie Mann, ladies and gentlemen, just gave us a note that, indeed, Bob Backlund has just accepted the challenge from Bob Spark Plug Holly. We shall have that matchup right here next week.
Backlund just might be taught a lesson.
Oh, I'm telling you this, Spark Plug has now stuck his nose where it doesn't belong.
Yokozuna, ready for action against Jason Storm. Now, what sort of strategy would you have against a man like Yokozuna?
I don't know, you're going to have to ask The Undertaker that. Wait a minute. Look at these idiots. Yoko will rest in peace. Let me remind them who won the last casket match, the last time he faced The Undertaker. You remind them, McMahon.
Well, of course, you're referring to the Royal Rumble, and indeed, actually, that was the last we had seen of the Undertaker for a long time.
Look at that, McMahon. The world hadn't seen legs like that since the Brontosaurus died out.
Yokozuna against Jason Storm as Mr. Fuji looks on. Yokozuna setting up Storm now. Off the rope and... Ooh. My goodness. See, you did that quite well, actually, almost as well as Maple. Say it again. Boom. Boom. There it
no,
is.
I'm
Come
not
on.
Saying that.
Huh?
It's not what I'm saying. I said,
oh, look at
wow,
that loud mouth. Jim what? Cornette, ladies and gentlemen, the American spokesperson, if you would, for Yokozuna.
What's this?
Oh!
Man. Forget about it.
Yokozuna would like very much to do just that to The Undertaker and then drag him over. Stuff him inside that casket. And it might be the last we will ever see of The Undertaker, should that occur, on the WWF Heart Attack Tour.
Look how proud Mr. Fuji is of Yokozuna. And look at Cornette. They couldn't be happier.
Oh, yes, they could, because if The Undertaker were resting in peace, for sure,
yeah,
they would be a lot happier.
Hey,
wait a minute.
Wait a minute, McMahon.
Did you hear that? Yes. The bone. And the discussion going on is the end.
Hey, hey, what look at this.
Paul Bear, ladies and gentlemen. Paul Bear is pushing it. This is pushing it.
Yokozuna over this way. Yokozuna.
Yokozuna looking for The Undertaker.
Look out, Paul Bear. Area. That's The Undertaker behind you.
And The Undertaker's going to be in that casket. The latest race.
Turn around. Backing right towards the casket. He's been turned around.
Is The Undertaker in there or not? Paul Bear waiting for Yokozuna to turn around.
Cornette, tell him to turn. Look, there it is.
Whoa. Yokozuna, obviously very afraid of the casket.
Is The Undertaker in it?
But he better get used to it. Yokozuna running away. He won't be able to run away, but he may be falling down.
He's not running, McMahon. He's not running.
He may be falling into the casket. We may see the last of Yokozuna.
When The Undertaker grabs him and shoves him down right into that. And Paul Bearer seals the lid as the lights go out on Yokozuna.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, that music can mean only one thing. Indeed, the man from Talladega, Alabama, joining us, Bob Spark Plug Holly, who next week will square off one-on-one with Bob Backlund. And what sort of a match can we expect, Bob, out of you and Backlund?
Let me tell you something, Bob Backlund. You're nothing but a bully. I've had to deal with bullies all my life. I've even had to deal with them on the racetrack. You know, there's people on the racetrack that don't care nothing about winning. All they want to do is put people in the wall. That's just like you, Bob Backlund. But you know what I did to those people that put me in the wall after the race was over? I went in the pits and I snatched them out of their race car. And that's exactly what I'm going to do to you, Bob Backlund. And I taught them a lesson, and I'm going to teach you a lesson next week right here. So you better be ready, because Bob Sparkplug Holly is going to be wide open, and I'm looking for you.
All right, thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen, Bob Sparkplug Holly. A standing ovation for the fighting champion here in the World Wrestling Federation, defended more times than anyone else, including Paranoid Bob.
Yeah, well, you know what that might end up giving Real Monsoon's feet, because I think Bret the Hitman Hart is burning the candle at both ends. He's got everybody breathing down his neck. Paul's got
Keep Bob. Quiet and let's listen.
I'm not through yet, Monsoon. I mean, Bob Backlund wants it. Definitely Owen wants it. Everybody wants it.
Will you stop?
All right, Bret. I know it's not easy being World Wrestling Federation champion. All the superstars have you as a target. Well, I'm sure you are aware that as of late, Bob Backlund has issued a challenge to you. Now, how do you feel about that?
You already beat Bob.
Bob Backlund.
No, he didn't.
You know, I respect Bob Backlund very much. And I sympathize with Bob Backlund, because I think Bob's losing his marbles. He keeps talking about, you know, that he's never been beaten. Bob, you already had your shot. You lost.
Give me a break.
By me. I've got a dozen wrestlers that all want title shots. They're all breathing down my neck.
I just said that.
They're all going to get their shots. Bob, you're just going to have to get back in line.
He's avoiding it.
All right, Brett, October 23rd. That's a date you cannot forget.
No, it's a day that I can't wait for. October 23rd is going to be the final day because I've had it. I've had it up to here with my brother Owen. Owen, this is it, brother. This is your last title shot. I don't want to see your face anymore in the ring. If I see it at the supper table or I see it at my mom's house, that's fine. But Owen, this is as far as it goes. This is our last title shot, and it's going to end right here in the middle of the ring, because there's only one way for Owen to go, and that's down.
What it is, Brett, is your last title defense.
All right, Brett. You know, coming back to Bob Backlund, why, he has actually given you an ultimatum. He says you can take the easy way out, and you can just hand him the belt, or you can make it hard on yourself, and he will come into the ring and take it from you.
Beat you again.
Bob Backlund, all I'm going to say is one thing. You were the very best of your generation. You were the best. No one even argues that or disputes it.
Mr. Bob Backlund.
But it's a new day. And Bob Backlund, all I can tell you is that I am the best there is, the best there was, and the best there ever will be of any generation.
Boy, aren't you full of yourself.
The excellence of execution has spoken. Did you get it, Owen? He doesn't want to see your face into place.
We're back, everyone, in Burlington, Vermont. Joining us now, ladies and gentlemen, is Lex Luger, who had a few words to say earlier on to the former WWF champion, Bob Backlund.
Lex Luger's my new hero.
He is, huh?
That's right.
Well, certainly,
pulled them
as far as this capacity crowd is concerned, they're behind him 100%. Backlund didn't have too much to say. Lex, there you are. Lex, what's up?
Well, you know, one thing I have to say to Bobby Backlund. Ever since I entered the sport of professional wrestling, I've heard about the legendary Bob Backlund, the finest technical wrestler ever to step into the ring. All I can judge Bob Backlund is in what I see now, and I don't like what I see. So what I'm doing right here, right now, is issuing a challenge to you, Bobby Backlund, a challenge to wrestle a new generation WWF wrestler. I'm issuing the challenge. Let's see what you got.
Thank you very much, Lex Luger.
Thank you.
questionably one of his mentors, the racing superstar Ernie Irvin, who, by the way, King, in the event you don't know, is very much looking forward to next racing season. He's doing extremely well and ready for action. And here comes another man, ready for action
and doing extremely well.
Backlund watching the towel footage from back in 1983. And that same towel is the one that Arnold Skolin, his former manager, threw in when Bob Backlund lost the championship on that fateful night in December of 83 in Madison Square Garden.
Just think, McMahon, he keeps that towel right around his neck, close to his heart, close to his mind, to remind him of that fateful night. The worst night of his life, McMahon. The worst night of his life caused by Arnold Skolin.
No, as far as I'm concerned, the worst moment of his life was last week right here on WWF Superstars when he put the cross-faced chicken wing on his former manager, the Hall of Famer Arnold Skolin.
I blame you for that, McMahon.
Oh, please.
Every time he gets close to you, he snaps. He showed what a man he was. He apologized last Monday night, didn't he?
Some apology. Apologizing for ever having Arnold Skolin as his manager. And Bob Sparkplug Holly's not about to fall for what may be a phony handshake from Bob Backlund.
Oh, Bob Sparkplug's about to fall, all right. At the hands of Bob Backlund. Wait and see.
And obviously, Bob Holly a little tenuous as it relates to locking up with the former WWF champion, Bob Backlund.
Tenuous? Explain to all of these idiots out there, that means scared.
Well, now we're getting into Bob Backlund's vocabulary, which we'll speak up a little bit later on. Look at this, and the tight waist applied, a quick reversal there. Nice maneuver into waist lock. Bob Sparkplug Holly.
I hope the spark plug's not going to try to match wrestling ability with the great Bob Backlund. Look at that.
There is no denying Bob Backlund's wrestling skill. In terms of technicality, one of the all-time greats. However, in terms of a few screws being loose.
Hey.
Well, enough said on that. And Bob Holly, an up-and-coming WWF superstar, certainly a part of the new WWF generation, against the rope here. Round and round the rope, Backlund to the corner. And Holly, very upset over Bob Backlund's actions last week. Thank goodness for Bob Holly coming down to help out to finally get Backlund to release the hold on his former manager, Arnold Skolin.
Bob Holly sticks his nose in somebody else's business, and now he's going to pay for it right here this week. Watch Bob Backlund here. You know what's going through his mind right now? You said
he's... I have no idea.
Well, I can tell you, he's looking at Bob Holly thinking, yeah, you're a part of the new generation.
Single leg takedown, nicely done.
He's going to show him what his generation is all about.
And back on releasing the hold. That's unusual.
He's a gentleman.
A gentleman.
In the ring and out.
Bob Backlund continuing to insist that he is still the legitimate. Nice takedown here by Bob. And look at that. And Holly can let him go, too.
Oh, no.
To play the humiliation factor.
Yeah, that's what Holly...
Buck Holly can play it just as well.
Oh, he's just trying to make a fool out of Bob Backlund. Backlund let him up because he's a gentleman. When I think of all the time that Bob Backlund spent going to visit little kids in hospitals, signing autographs, and then for the fans to turn on him the way they have.
A scoop here by Backlund. The fans turn, and a slam. Backlund backing up.
He's a true role model. Look at him.
He was at one time a fantastic role model. He was indeed the quintessential, if you would, all-American boy. No longer. Bob Backlund, as a result of losing the match from the Hitman Brothers, a scoop again, and another slam.
Yeah.
And a kick out by Sparkplug Holly. Bob Holly with a drop kick down goes Backlund. Backlund back up, arm drag takedown, nicely done by Bob Holly.
Now, earlier on, you made the note about Holly doesn't want to match wrestling skill with Bob Backlund. I think he is doing extremely well.
Well, I'm a little bit surprised, to be honest with you.
Uh-huh, and Bob Holly applying the arm bar. Maybe he did a cross-faced chicken wing. Maybe Bob Backlund gets a little dose of his own medicine.
Oh, come on.
He dished out to his former manager last week.
Yeah, and I just won $10 million in the publisher's clearing out sweepstakes.
You did? I didn't hear about that.
Oh, come on, McMahon.
Back in a standing position. Backlund now reversing things on Bob Holly. And a nice reversal there, and a takedown. Nicely done by Bob Holly. Backlund recently making note of the WWF champion Bret Hart claimed that the Hitman is engulfed in a river of lies.
That's right.
He's a man who is quagmired in a sea of hypocrisy.
Yeah.
What is he talking about?
Well, that's almost like the King's English. Let me just explain that to you and some of those simple-minded people out there. He also says that he's been ostracized. This is Bob Backlund terminology.
and that the belt was procured in the wrong way. Do you know what procured means?
I know this. Oh, down goes Backlund.
Get up, Bob. That means the belt was taken in the wrong way.
I see.
And he's been ostracized by the fans and by you too, McMahon. Oh, that means you all have turned on Bob Backlund.
Bob Backlund had his chance. He thought he won the WWF Championship, and many thought he did as well. But unfortunately, Backlund counting his chickens before they hatch, and the hitman Bret Hart able to put Backlund in a small package, and Backlund's dreams shattered.
Yeah, that's where he comes in, the engulfed in a river of lies. Bret Hart believing that he's still the champion. As far as I'm concerned, I think Bob Backlund really beat him.
It was close. It was an extraordinary matchup. Not much, I'll grant you. But nonetheless, in the record book, it shows Bret Hart the victor. And Bob Holly just may be the victor here this week as well. Holly now being set up, coming off for the road, and Backlund goes down. Holly from the far side. Oh, yeah. Oh, my goodness. Did you see that? Holly in some trouble. We'll be back as the match resumes. Stay with us. We're back with more WWF action. Bob Spark Plug Holly continues to be in a bit of trouble.
Look at that face, McMahon.
Which one? Backlund's face? We saw his face last week when he looked down at his hands with that goofy look after he put the cross-faced chicken wing on Arnold Skolin. His manager. Oh, wait a minute. Nice maneuver there by Bob Holly.
When he snapped last week, is that what you're talking about?
Wait a minute. Backlund. Backlund measuring Bob Holly.
Oh, getting. Getting from behind.
Is he going to go for it? Is he going to go for that cross-faced chicken wing? There's that look. That maniacal look. No, he goes right back to the reverse chin lock.
This is the great thing about Mr. Bob Backlund. You never know what he's thinking, but you can depend on this. If he ever sees a white towel, that will also make him snap.
Now, wait a minute. It doesn't take much for Bob Backlund to snap at all. What's this white towel stuff?
Well, can you imagine? Let me give a little word of warning out there to any of you waiters. If Bob Backlund were to come into your restaurant, don't go over to him and try to put a white napkin in his lap. I can tell you that. He might just slap that chicken wing crossface on them.
Nothing would surprise me, especially considering last week when Backlund challenged the fans if anyone in the audience would want to come in and try and escape from his cross-faced chicken wing, and Lex Luger came down the ringside. And I think Bob Backlund, I haven't heard the last of Lex Luger, but he may have heard the last of this man. No! No! Bob Holly's still into the match. Talk about white flags. Bob Holly has seen his share of white flags as well as checkered flags. Holly trying to escape. Yes, he does!
You keep wanting to talk about what a great race car driver Bob Holly is. You know, to be honest with you, you know who the greatest NASCAR driver is of all time?
Who's that?
Well, he's kin to Double J, Dale Jarrett.
Dale Jarrett, huh?
That's right. He's hot.
Bob Holly's got to go into cover here. One. Nope. There we go. And a kick out.
Oh, I thought he had him.
Bob Spark Plug Holly on his way to race, ladies and gentlemen, in Pensacola, Florida, in December in the Snowball Derby. We'll be giving you more on that later on. Look at that maneuver. Nicely done. Bob Spark Plug Holly with a gut-wrench suplex, reversal on Backlund. And reaching the end, single leg takedown. Bob Holly again. Come on, Bob. Holly with some momentum.
You pulling for Backlund?
Am I pulling for Backlund?
You said, come on, Bob.
I'm talking about Bob Holly, not Bob Backlund. To the buckle.
And Holly moving in. Here comes Backlund. He's going to come sailing out of the corner. Yes. Monkey flipped into a
cover. No cover. Right back up. The former WWF champion now coming off the rope. A drop kick. It down goes Backlund again.
A cover. One, two, and
whoa. Almost a count of three. Bob Backlund. Obviously, his style is one that wears an opponent down.
Backlund coming up, and this time, yes! One, count of two, and a power slam.
Oh, no.
What do you think would happen if I stand up and wave this white towel here I got over here?
What do I think would happen?
Maybe if Bob could see this.
I think all of a sudden, Dink would come down along with the...
Wait a minute, no!
Oh, he got him! He got him!
A cross-faced chicken wing!
That's it!
Backlund has the leg centered as well, and Bob Holly wastes no time in surrendering.
It's over, McMahon, it's over!
One of the most painful holds ever in the World Wrestling Federation.
And look at this, Backlund's not letting it go. Come on, get in there! Get in there, ref!
Backlund, cinching in the cross-faced chicken wing, he won't let go!
Finally releasing. Look at that look. That's that same look we saw last week when he did the same thing to Arnold Skolin, his former manager.
It's a look of a winner.
This guy snapped.
Come on.
Admit it.
Is there an escape? Is there some sort of reversal to the cross-faced chicken wing? Backlund claims there is not. He claims there's no counter.
Well, there absolutely there can't be. Do you think he would make such a bold statement that he would retire from wrestling permanently if somebody could get out of that hole?
Take a look at this man. Thank you.
Yes, he's a gentleman. Come on, show some respect.
Thank you, sure. Yeah, just like he apologized last Monday night.
Razor Ramon battling Yokozuna this Monday night. The title's up for grabs.
No telling what's going to happen on Monday Night Raw.
Listen up.
Chicks and gents, to another edition of the Heartbreak Hotel, where you can hang with the two hippest, hoppinest cats in all of the World Wrestling Federation, Big Daddy Cool Diesel, and yours truly, the HB Kid, Shawn Michaels, your World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Champion.
Oh! You know what? That lamp
now,
is cool,
too. Ladies and gentlemen, the Heartbreak Kid and Big Daddy Cool.
All right, listen up,
love practical jokes as much as the next guy. Am I right, big man?
Correct you are, sir, yes.
Thank you very much. But what's been going on lately between Jerry the King Lawler
That's me.
And Doink the Clown is even getting a little out of hand, even for the new generation of the World Wrestling Federation. So right here on the Heartbreak Hotel, we're gonna nip this thing in the bud.
Good. Great.
So I'd like to bring out my guest at this time, Doink the Clown and his little buddies, Dink and Wink.
All right, Dink and Wink, accompanying Doink the Clown. There they are.
Man, oh, man.
Yes, he's the Prince of Pranks, all right. Doink the Clown.
What's uglier and dumber than one clown?
I think you're going to tell us.
Three clowns.
Uh-huh.
Look at that.
Doink, Dink, and Wink.
Are you doing funny?
A lot's been going on lately, as everybody knows.
Oh, wait a minute. I think...
Hey!
Between you, Doink the Clown...
That's Dink.
...and Jerry the King Lawler.
That's Wink.
That's Stink.
Now, as we know, you have got your little sidekick.
These guys are having some fun,
all
huh?
All right?
Santa Claus gave him to me.
Right. Santa Claus gave him to you.
It's my present.
Right. Okay. Now... Jerry the King Lawler decided he'd had enough of your antics, so he decided to even things up a little bit and introduce to the World Wrestling Federation Queasy.
Right.
That's right, Queasy.
Now, you couldn't just let it lie at that, now could you? No, no, you had to take it another step farther. So now, we've got Dink, Wink, Queasy and Sleazy.
I think we're going to need a scorecard for this.
Would they stand still?
The Clown, this is even a little out of hand, even for a clown like you.
Hey, guys, calm down a minute.
Can you believe the nerve of those little runts?
Oh, Your Majesty.
What?
Hey, Kingy. I got
like
a surprise
this.
For you.
I like it when he calls you Kingy.
You know what it is?
What?
No, as a matter of fact, I don't have any idea, and we don't like surprises here on the Heartbreak Hotel.
Well, I want to tell you, right here on the Heartbreak Hotel, you know what it is? It's pink.
Pink.
That's right.
What?
Oh, wait a minute, I got it, I got it.
What?
This is it.
The bed now. Look at the heart-shaped bed.
Please, nobody can control these guys. If you can't control them,
I cannot believe this, McMahon. Grab one of them.
Dink
and Wink. We should just join him and have some fun.
We're having fun at your expense, Jerry the King Lawler.
Pull that green hair out of him, Deezer. Look at this.
Charlie, we need
you. Try and push pink a moment ago. Dink, Dink, Wink, pink. Look at this.
They're having fun on the Heartbreak Hotel.
And we're going to have more fun indeed
when we return with more WWF. What do you have to say for yourself, King?
This is ridiculous! Doink, Dink, Wink, Pink!
There are only two sure things in life, death and taxes. Like this poor soul they just brought in here. Obviously, he knows about death. However, something's just not sitting right with me. I'm wondering how many people would try to escape paying taxes by getting put 6 feet into the ground. Like this so-called poor soul. I bet when he was alive, he conveniently forgot to pay his taxes. Or maybe he just did it intentionally. But in my line of work, that's known as a red flag situation. So maybe this poor soul is in line for an audit by me, IRS. And remember, even after they bring your frozen carcass into the funeral home, you still have to pay your taxes.
From IRS and Ted DiBiase, how nice.
Isn't that a face you'd like to punch right there, IRS?
Yes, but nonetheless, ladies and gentlemen, here comes a man. Here comes a man who was on the zone. Yes, the action zone yesterday afternoon on USA. Ready for action here tonight on Monday Night Raw. Adam Bomb.
This is a big boy right here.
Phil Apollo knows he's in there against a superstar. And Apollo just made, oh yeah.
Check that out.
And you can bet Apollo's been doing just that, checking out Adam Bomb, setting up. Oh, wait a minute, what's he doing now? Here he comes. Apollo hammering away on Adam Bomb. Bomb turned his back. I don't care who you are. You can't turn your back on any superstar in WWF today.
Razor Ramon did that against Yokozuna, but he was able to,
he got lucky. That's
why. Right, exactly. Lucky is the word.
Leapfrog by Adam Bomb. Apollo over the hip. Nicely done. All right, Randy Savage. Here we go. A scoop and a slam. Let's have a little drum roll, please. And here he goes, the highlight of Monday Night Raw. It's Randy Savage reading promo copy for the USA Network. Go ahead, Randy.
This drum roll. Tune in for three nights of outrageous moving comedy with USA's very special tribute to John Candy. Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday night at 9, 8 Central Time.
Yes, indeed. John Candy here on USA.
Did you like that drum roll?
Yes, actually, I did.
I can also do the cymbals, too.
Apollo probably thinks he's hearing cymbals in his head at this moment. Apollo, his strategy backfiring a bit, raising the arm of Adam Bomb. What a maneuver to the buckle. And Apollo, ladies and gentlemen, up. Nice suplex by Adam Bomb. Adam Bomb, part of Guts and Glory, the tag team elimination matchup. Yes, Guts and Glory to face the Million Dollar Team in the Survivor Series. Look at this maneuver. Adam Bomb on the top rope. Adam Bomb with a leap in. Down goes Apollo.
Apollo was dazed before that happened. Now you know he's dazed.
Yeah, I'm saying. Speaking of dazed, could you see the look on Dana Carvey's face when President Bush came on Saturday Night Live and did Dana Carvey?
He was speechless for just a split second.
Whoa, yes. You can bet Apollo is speechless now. A three count. And Adam Bomb with a very impressive victory here tonight on Monday Night Raw.
3 Mile Island lives.
Yes, indeed, Adam Bomb. One of the favorites here on Monday Night Raw. Really coming into his own as of late, Randy Savage.
Yes, he is. He's a dark horse finishing strong.
A dark horse, huh? Wait a minute. Bob Backlund coming in. Bob Backlund, ladies and gentlemen. A cross face, chicken wing, applied on Adam Bomb. Bob Backlund, whom we're scheduled to see next week against Lex Luger. Came in from behind, and down goes Adam Bomb. Look at this. Backlund, who put the cross face, chicken wing on a writer for the magazine. He put it on his own manager, Arnold Skullin. He put it on Bob Spark Plug Holly. He challenged someone from this capacity crowd in Burlington, Vermont. And look at this. Now he sneaks up from behind and applies it on Adam Bomb. He's lost it. Backlund is trying to make a statement indeed. And is anyone listening? You can bet Lex Luger is listening. Lex Luger watching up. Luger against Backlund next week right here on Monday Night Raw. We'll be back with more action. Welcome back.
Bret Hart, it's been signed, sealed, and delivered for Survivor Series. The WWF title is on the line. And in that contract, I would like one stipulation. Let's have a submission match. The sharpshooter against the chicken wing. I have to put the chicken wing on you to win. And you're gonna maybe try to put the sharpshooter on me. And in this match, we'll find out just who's gonna get the towel thrown in on them in Survivor Series 1994.
Oh, yes! The Survivor Series! Yokozuna, a casket match! This time your friends won't be able to help you! No one will be able to help you! The World Wrestling Federation has insisted that Chuck Norris, the fifth degree black belt, be at ringside as a special troubleshooter referee! And you, Yokozuna, are going in the casket!
Yokozuna, can you look into the eye of the tiger and survive twice? You had all the cards stacked in your favor the first time. Now you must play on my rules, and my rules are final.
So, you thought that being 6 feet under, you wouldn't have to pay your taxes anymore. Well, you were wrong. Because I knew last week when I thought you were a tax cheat, I was right, and I was. You are a tax cheat. Well, you were. And it seems, after reviewing your September 15th quarterly taxes, I've found a slight error. You see, I'm sure you and your whole family enjoyed your little girl's birthday dinner. But you see, that dinner wasn't tax deductible. You owe $121.37. So maybe if I repossess these fresh flowers, that'll settle your debt. But wait a minute. If you've cheated once, I'm sure you've cheated more than once. So maybe this requires further investigation by me, IRS. So remember, even after you're 6 feet under, you still have to pay your taxes.
Jeff Hart Attack Tour, let's take you back now to a recent interview conducted with the Million Dollar Team.
Ladies and gentlemen, Ted DiBiase's Million Dollar Team. Take a look at him.
And you will be fun.
All right, Ted DiBiase, we're talking Survivor Series. And we're talking the Million Dollar Team versus Guts and Glory. What about it?
It's like this, McMahon. It's very simple. The name says it all. Survivor Series. Survival is what it's all about. And I have put together a team, a Million Dollar Team of survivors. As a matter of fact, you might call them the Eliminators, because that's what they do, and that's what they have to do, as you well know, to win a Survivor Series. Two teams of five on each team, and to win a Survivor Series, you must eliminate each and every one of your opponents till there's nobody's left. So I've got it all figured out. I've got something for everybody, Luger, on your loser team. First of all, you've got Adam Bomb. Adam Bomb, you very bravely accepted an open challenge from the Beast of the East, Bam Bam Bigelow, and I said then there would come a time when you would have to pay. Survivor Series, the Beast from the East is gonna take you out. One man gone. Then you've got the anchor of this team, and he's a big man. 500 pounds worth of Mabel, a tall order, a lot to take out. Well, Mabel, you know what I have for you. I have the biggest beast of the jungle, the biggest Kong of the jungle, King Kong Bundy, whose reputation speaks for itself. Two men gone, McMahon.
So now then, I suppose it's five against three. Is that correct?
Exactly. And now we come to the smoking guns. And due to a very lucrative deal that I've made with Mr. James E. Cornette, he has graciously given me the services of the heavenly bodies, who are more than willing to take out the smoking guns, Mr. Cornette.
I see. Well, Mr. Cornette, managing the heavenly bodies, you described them as their physique is heavenly. I wonder how you would describe your physique then.
Let me tell you something. We're not here talking about physiques. What we're here talking about is survival. And I have always
always, always wanted to survive long enough in my life to do a business deal with the Million Dollar Man, and now the time has finally come. And let me say this to Luger's losers, you've bitten off a big bite of a triple-decker trouble sandwich at the Survivor Series, because believe me, any time, any place that we get a chance to get our hands on the smoking guns and disarm them or cause them to misfire or put their smoke out by stomping it into the ground, that's exactly what the heavenly bodies are going to do. We would have almost done it for free, but with the kind of... I'll agree, Jim Cornette and the heavenly bodies got a price for the Million Dollar Man, brother.
Well, if all of that occurs, then it's going to be your team intact. Five men against one single individual left. Am I right?
Very good, McMahon. That's right, Luger. We didn't forget about you, the biggest loser of all. As a matter of fact, Tatanka would love nothing better than to climb in the ring and take you out all by himself. That's what he wants, but that's not the game plan, and Tatanka is a game player. For you, Lex Luger, are going to be left intentionally for last, and you will have to run the gauntlet of the entire million-dollar team. And McMahon, when it's all over, said and done, it's not going to be very pretty, because Luger, not only are we going to eliminate you from the Survivor Series, we're going to get you out of the World Wrestling Federation once and for all.
The Million Dollar Team, Ted DiBiase.
The Survivor Series, baby! Razor Ramon's team against Ooh. Double J's team! We're ready! Look at the power! Look at the size! Look at the...
Oh! That's right, Captain! The British Bulldog is taking his eyes right on you, Anvil! And you, King of Hearts, Owen Hart! Isn't that right, guys?
You know, Bulldog, he gonna take care of the hearts. The Shrinkers, they got their eyes on Diesel and the Heartbreak Kid. Whoa. The 1-2-3 Kid and Razor Ramon, we looking for any kind of action, baby. But one thing's for sure, at Survivor Series, this team will survive.
Afraid of the casket match.
No, hey, wait a minute, Yoko. Don't say that word. You know the little thing, that word, that C word. Go ahead.
Well, just to prove it to you, not so long ago, Paul Bearer pushed the box down to the ring after a Yokozuna match. Now, when he saw the casket, he fell to the ground, and he ran back to the dressing room. Now, he was scared.
Now, let me explain something. There's a big difference between a little phobia and a deathly fear. And I've said before, and I'll say again, Yokozuna has claustrophobia. It's a slight fear of phobia of dark, closed-in places. It's not a fear of the Undertaker, and it's certainly not a fear of the box. As far as Yokozuna running away, he was afraid that the Undertaker had about 10 or 12 of his friends locked up in that box, ready to jump out on him. The Undertaker is a guy that would have 12 people jump one, not Yokozuna. He fights people single-handedly.
Oh, single-handedly?
Single-handedly. Just like he did at the Royal Rumble when he beat the Undertaker.
Wait a minute. At the Royal Rumble, we saw no less than 10 superstars coming to Yokozuna's aid to defeat the Undertaker.
No, that was just 10 of Yokozuna's friends coming down to get a closer look when they saw history being made that Yokozuna was taking a legend like the Undertaker, slapping him around like he owned him, and stuck him in that box and closed the lid.
Well, you know what? To make sure history does not repeat itself, there has been a special troubleshooting referee appointed for this match. And he is none other than martial arts expert, Texas Ranger, Chuck Norris. because The Undertaker's on the lam. He's running scared. But Yokozuna is not scared of anybody, even Chuck Norris. Now, Chuck Norris is a martial arts expert. The man, his whole body is a deadly weapon. Everywhere he goes, in every town, he's got to register his body with the FBI, the CIA, the ASPCA, and every other governmental agency that there is. Because the man at any time is liable to go off and lay waste to half a city. But Chuck Norris, I guarantee you this. If Bruce Lee was still alive to this day, Yokozuna could take him and pop him in his mouth like a chiclet and store him like a chipmunk stores his food for the winter, brother. And that's for real. So you better stay out of Yokozuna's way. And that goes for The Undertaker, too. Because you see, Undertaker, at the Survivor Series, you are going to get stuffed in your own box with those pretty pearl handles and that nice silk interior that Paul Bearer has lovingly crafted with his own hands. That's going to be your final resting place, Undertaker, because when the man, the monster, Yokozuna, gets in that ring, he's coming to do one thing and one thing only, and that's bring the curtain down on the career of The Undertaker. It's all on the line. The final conflict, the last time that they'll meet, and it's Survivor Series. I guarantee you, Undertaker, you will never rest in peace because your body and your soul will belong to the living legend himself, the monster, the mighty Yokozuna. And that is the moral of the story.